Unity AD tutorial. Today I'll show you how to import tracking data to 3D Studio Max. To import your tracking data to 3D Studio Max, go to Scripter, Run Script, and choose your Max Script file. Press G to grid. Okay. To import our background, press M. Bitmap. And choose your file. Then press A and drag it to environment map and instance. Okay. Then go to views, viewport background, environment background, and check. That's it. Okay. Go to M and use it as environment. Okay, to see only the picture, go to camera and show save frame. That's it. Okay, now we can build our scene. Okay, like this, like you can make a box. Okay, now you can build your scene like a basic scene, or you can download one, or make a like a big scene, or you can open your scene first. Okay, it's a basic scene, but I did it before. Continue. Then import your tracking data script in Rust script. What you need now is to render your scene. Okay, so go to your render setup and the most important thing is your aspect ratio. Okay, match it with your sequence 1920x1080. That's it. Okay, then choose your save output, your render output. Choose to check it, make it like this. Choose go to files and choose your blaze. If you have like alpha channel, make it BNG. If there's no alpha channel, JPEG sequence will be fine. And rename it and save. Now I will render it and I will see you after render. Okay, now render is done. What we need now is ambient occlusion map, okay? To make ambient occlusion map, first go to render setup. And make it mental ray. Then mental ray. Okay. Surface. And choose ambient occlusion map. Okay. Now set up your ambient occlusion. You can make it like max distance like 10 centimeters. And spread like 1 and samples like 20. Okay, we can make it like 20 centimeters. Okay. Then go to your render setup and processor. Okay, material override, enable, and make it your material, your ambient occlusion. Okay, and instance. Okay. Material override will make all your 3D models like have only one material, and it's ambient reflective occlusion material. Okay. Then go to common and save your file and change your file path. Okay, files, and make a new file. Name it like AO ambient occlusion and okay. Save it as JPEG, save, and make a render. It will not take a lot of time like the real render or the RGB render. That's it, render is done, and that's for part 3. Don't forget to like and subscribe to see part 4. In part 4 we'll make a compositing tutorial. and After Effects with a green screen, new attack technique. So see you in back 4, goodbye.